Hi, I'm Tim. Welcome to our channel, and thanks for logging on. If you enjoy these videos, do me a favor and subscribe to our YouTube channel right here at Watchbox Reviews. I would really appreciate it, and I promise to update daily. If you love this watch, you can see it and purchase it on our website, thewatchbox.com. And today, we discuss a 2018 offering from Hublot. The crazy folks from Neon offer the Hublot Spirit of Big Bang King Gold Blue, and it's all of these things. It's the spirit, not the exact form of the Big Bang, with a combination of King Gold, red gold, and blue accents in a combination of composite, rubber, and leather. The timepiece is big, but it's big in Hublot's fashion. That is to say, a watch that fits a human-sized wrist, as they understand you can build a bigger watch, but not a bigger client. The timepiece is broad, 45 millimeters across the, well, let's call it the 3-9 span of the case, not including the crown. It's not as thick as you'd expect, at only 14.6 millimeters. This is well within the realm of wearability beneath a jacket cuff. Not a dress shirt, but a jacket. Lug to lug, it's big at 56.3 millimeters, but you can see the curvature of the case, the camber, and the downward, almost reverse ducktail thrusts of the lug ends. They do wrap the watch around the wrist. This is something that Hublot's Spirit of Big Bang, Richard Mille, and Franck Muller have done well for a number of years, arcing the back of a big watch around a human wrist. The timepiece is heavy, king gold indeed, and king gold refers to the redness of the gold. If you wonder what's the difference between Hublot king gold and magic gold, king gold is red, magic gold is hard. The strap is, as per Hublot's fashion, a fusion of large rectangular scale medium blue alligator leather with a semi-gloss finish and a monotone stitch, leather and rubber underneath and on the sides. And you can see the rubber has been nicely tailored to swell and match the width of the composite insert on the case flank. So visually, it's quite coherent. A combination of red gold, king gold, titanium polished H-pattern Hublot bolts, and inside you can see it's blackened steel with the Hublot logo on the interior. It's a twin trigger release. You must press both triggers to pop this open, not friction fit. It can't accidentally come undone. And then there is a minderless system, so you size it and then you tuck it underneath the other side of the strap so there are no loops, there's no excess length flapping in the breeze. It's a very clean look once on the wrist. And it allows you to size this in a jiffy, and there's no planting or anchoring screw inside the clasp, something for which I cannot thank Hublot enough. The case is surprisingly complex. It's almost like a little piece of architecture on your wrist, as it has some of the imagery of a building or a large machine under construction. The frame, the works, the guts of the machine, somewhat visible and brought from the inside out. You can see the backing plate of the case, the composite insert with the screws blazing on the side, the bezel gasket, and then the bezel atop the case top, and even the case top with its lug hood slightly raised above the center. A wonderfully sculpted and contoured piece with a combination of satin finished tops and a mirrored bevel that runs the entire circumference of the case top, as well as another bevel, all of high polish, that runs the entire circumference of the upper bezel. Now here's where things get interesting, at least in finishing terms. We'll talk about the movement in a moment, but there is a wonderful blasted interior to the hollows of the bezel, and you can see that the bezel bolts themselves feature differential finish with polish around their rim and then a blasted interior. That's impressive attention to detail on a component that small. The dial is all open in the fashion pioneered by the Hublot Aero dials on the Classic Fusion and Big Bang series. You can see everything, and what you can see effectively is the caliber 4700, Zenith El Primero, doing business as the Hublot HUB4700. But it's fairly easy to read because the applique hour indices outboard are cantilevered over the center, and there is a blue metallic reflective double stripe that runs the full circumference of the outer dial. One is superimposed with hash marks for the minutes and seconds over the inner. And then you can see the cantilever of those indices, making for fairly easy reading by day and even easier reading by night. You can see a skeletonized date wheel that happens to show up when it's superimposed over a black panel at approximately 4:30. And there is a register for chronograph hours, chronograph minutes up to 30, and then a minimalist counterweighted, or I should say counterbalanced dial with a constant seconds at 9 to counterbalance the minutes at 3, and the Hublot logo ghosted onto the underside of a sapphire. The sapphire itself fully cambered, so it traces the arc of the case just as the bezel, the case sides, and even the case back with its own cambered crystal do trace the arc of the case. The Spirit of Big Bang bowed at Baselworld 2014, and it's had a Zenith El Primero or Zenith Elite caliber from the beginning, so they've always been impressively powered. And you can see the crown is truly regal. in that it features a rich, deep, and sharp knurling that makes the screw-down unit very easy to manipulate, with the triggers for the chronograph being a combination of blue rubber and red gold. Turn it all over, and I think this is where a lot of our viewers are going to find their favorite part of the watch. 31 joules, 50 hours, bidirectional automatic winding, 36,000 vibrations per hour, that is 10 beats per second. This is the Zenith El Primero Caliber 400 doing business as the Hublot Caliber 4700. As ever, it's a good-looking automatic chronograph with a column wheel actuator for the function selection, and the nice thing is you can actually see the levers and horns interacting with the column wheel somewhat better on this large and expansive caseback than you often can on Zenith's own watches. The other fun feature is that you can see the lateral clutch of the El Primero moving in, out of, and into contact with the center wheel, and then you can watch the recentering hammers fall on the hard cams at the center of the movement when you reset it. The El Primero keeps no secrets. You can really see everything, and against the ear it has that distinctive double-step heartbeat of an El Primero caliber. Of course, it also has the smooth sweep of an El Primero chronograph seconds hand. See this one and make this Hublot Zenith Hybrid yours on the watch box. And we're back with the Hublot Spirit of Big Bang. Note all the sub-registers are fully lumed. This is an automatic winding, 100-meter water-resistant, robustly lumed sports chronograph. It is a sports watch. A Miami sports watch, but a sports watch. See it by the light of day and make it yours on the watch box.